Hello friends, welcome back. Last video we saw how to save a user. After saving user, there are some roles automatically get associated with the user object through many-to-many relationship. Now we're going to see some more functionality part of many-to-many relationship. Here. Now I want to save a role. While saving role, I want to add some users on the fly. Okay. In the previous example, user controller, just whenever add a user, automatically role get added, role get inserted in the user table, in the role table, right? But when you add a role, I want to add a user. Okay. If you want to do that, there are some additional code we need to do. See here, I'm going to comment out this section everything now. I have all the data. I don't have any data here. Okay, now I'm going to save a role. Let's see what's happening. When you look at the role, there is a two field role object. Apart from that, there is a user list I defined here. My expectation is I want to save whenever save role object, I want to add a user object also. Let's see it's happening or not. Server is started now. Now these are role. Okay, role, this is suresh@gmail.com. Roles, I want to add accountant and admin role to the Suresh, then address list. Address list. Okay, there are as per this request, a role user table should populated. There are two roles should inserted in the role table and one address information added in the address table. Okay, let's see whether it's happening or not. See here, there is a I'm getting a role ID as a 18. The rest of the thing are coming as a null. Let's see what's going on. The database. See, user table does not have anything. Address table also does not have anything. Role table having a role is added. Role description name, nothing is there. Why nothing is there? Oh, sorry guys, I made a mistake. This is not a JSON request for role. This is a JSON request for creating a user. Okay. Where is that? This what is it? These are write requests. Okay. That's the reason unexpected happened in when we pop the invalid request. Okay. So when you look at here, there is a, I want to add a role called guru. Role name is a guru, the guru description, some guru description I'm giving here. Role description, then username is a kishore@gmail.com, bharathan@gmail.com. Okay, here according to this JSON, I want to insert role information. Whenever I add this role, I want to add this role to these two users, kishore@gmail.com, bharathan@gmail.com. Okay, let's see it's happening or not. Yeah, so role is added, role number is 19, role name is guru, the description is guru description. When you look at the table, let's see what's happening. Yeah, here you can see here there are two users inserted, Kishore and Bharathan. This request I have not added address, so address must be the empty here. No address. The role, when you look at the role, there will be a one role get added. When you see user underscore role does not have anything here. This is the problem I was facing. Now I'm able to create a user able to get a role, but that association is not happening properly. Association is not happening properly. Okay, so the association we need to set explicitly. That's when I add a user, right? When I add a new user, that time user added, role added, role underscore user underscore role alpha, everything happened by JPA itself. But when you do the reverse process, I want to, whenever I add a role, I want to add a user. In that case, JPA is not doing a association here, just inserting user under role and user. For that only, I did some changes. The role controller. These are the changes. Nothing I did. The role is a request body, right? From the role, I'm getting the user. Here, when you look at the JSON, there are two users, right? Coming as a user list. Okay, I'm iterating that user. Each user having a role, right? Each user having the this role, right? So when you look at the user table, there is a user list. You can see here user list, right? Okay. So whenever I iterate user object, I'm getting the roles. I'm getting the role. If you want to set a role into the user, I want to set as a list. That's the reason I'm initializing the array list. I'm adding this role to in the user object. Got it, right? See, from the role, I'm getting the user list. Okay, getting the user list. I'm iterating the user. Inside the for loop, I'm initializing the role object, role list. Each user, I will get a one role. Each user, I'm adding this role coming from request body. I'm adding this role which is coming from request body. Then I'm explicitly setting that role in the inside user. Explicitly setting inside user. For example, let's say here, when you look at that, this particular user object, right? That user, I don't have user information is there. I don't have any role here. For example, that meaning, when you say user, we have a user list, but when I look at the JSON, I don't have a role information. I'm passing only role information. That's the reason association is not happening. I wasn't expecting to set it manually. So what I'm doing, from the request body, I'm taking the list of user. I'm iterating that user. Each iteration, I am initializing the role list. Inside the role list, I am adding this role here, then setting that role list into user. After doing this, the association is happening properly between the user and role. Now I'm going to stop the server, run it again. Before that, I want to clean my database now. These are all definite. So we don't have any data now. Okay, server is started now. Now we're going to again sending the same request. What I'm doing here is this role, right? This entire role coming as a request body here. Okay. When you look at the request body, we have a user list. Inside a user list, I don't have this role. That's the reason I am setting this role to each user here. Okay, now I'm setting the request. See, again the response got successfully. When look at the table, user is created, we don't have address, role is created, user role. See, user ID 1617, I have a role ID 2020. See, role ID 20 associated with user ID 1617. See here, user 1617 created. Okay. So if you want to add a role while you're creating a user, that is the straightforward we can do. But if you want to add a role at the time of creating a role, for that we need to do some manual code. some line of code we have to write. Through this, you can achieve that. Okay. Now I want to view all the rules. Sorry, view all the users. Let's. I'll going to add one more user. Let me going to add one more user. Two user. How many users we have now? Let's see. I think we have two users, right? Yeah. Two users we have. Okay. I want to display all the users. How to do that? Go to get user. See here, I am getting the all the user now using this particular get. When you look at a JSON viewer. So required 17, we have a same rules, right? I am able to display all the users. How it's happening this? Here we have some trick. When you look at role table. Here I mentioned a JSON back reference. Let me comment out this particular annotation. Now restarting my server. When you put get all user, right? Get all user. Where is the get all user? See, get all user. Just I'm fetching all the user. That's it. Nothing special code. User repository dot get find all return all the user. That user I am returning here. I am printing that information part of responsibility. That's it. I am doing. So server started. Now I want to perform the same operation. See here, I'm getting some lot of things I'm getting. When you look at here, I'm getting some error. Cannot null send error after response has been committed. This gives some error. What is this? Okay, stack flow over. Some error is coming. Something happening. Never back answer. After removing this particular annotation, what this annotation is doing? I'm going to stop the server now. Let's keep going. Okay. Problem here is whenever I want to fetch a user information, I'm saying get all user, right? Get all user. So this object get populated. I have a two user meta database. When I take a first user, this information get populated properly. When I populate this particular role information, role also get populated. I am going here inside a role. Again, this role object having a user. Now it will go on to try to populate again here. It will go and try to populate again here. It will go. This is a circular reference. It's called a circular reference. It keep happening, right? It's keep happening. That's the reason I am getting like that error. This is not a Hibernate or JP error. This is the JSON error. Whenever generate JSON, it's trying to convert the Hibernate object to the JSON. That time, what's happening? It's going to the user, generate the JSON, going into the roles, again going to the user. It's keep happening. It's a circular reference problem. They say okay. And to avoid that particular error, we need to use JSON back reference. There are many ways to resolve this issue. This is one of the issues, JSON back reference. If I use this JSON back reference annotation, this will do this magic. This will go on and fix that error. It will not do again and again. Okay. This is a use of a JSON back reference. I'm going to start again. Okay, I'm going to again sending a request. For now, I'm getting it properly, right? So I'm getting all the things. Okay, next one is deleted. Delete scenario. My database I designed is deleted flag, right? But I'm not using this field now. I want to delete manually. I want to show some delete operation through JPA. So I'm not using this. I'm not updating 0 to 1. 1 meaning deleted, 0 meaning not deleted. That's what I told him when I start this hyphen extension JPA topic. But now this example, I will not show this example. I'm not using this particular column for delete flag. I want to delete physically from the database. So I want to show how what's happening when you do delete operation in the JPA in the case of many to many relationship. Okay. When you notice in this code, the previously I am saying cascaded equal to all. Now I mention. Now I am going to mention one by one. Okay, I don't want to do that. I will tell reason why I did this now. Okay, I am going to say all. Like that, I am going to say here also all. The server started now. Now I want to run delete operation. There's only one delete. What is the user ID? User ID is I have a 16 and 17. Let me delete 17. So deletion status 200. Okay. You look at the database, I can see delete. Oh, sorry. Whatever. Deleted 17, right? I delete user, I'm passing delete user by ID. Delete by user ID. I pass one 17, right? 17. User slash 17. Deleted. My expectation is to delete only 17 user. I still did everything. Okay, let me try again. Post roles, post I want user. Roles, status roles. Okay, I want to use the same thing again. Okay, 1819. I want delete 18 now. Delete from user 18. It's strange. It's deleting everything. Hi friends. Whenever pass one ID, but it's deleting everything, right? It's something strange, but there is a reason I found. I think that is a reason. Okay. For example, when you look at the roles and user, right? This I am making a cascade equal to all. Cascade equal to all. Whenever delete a user, that user associated roles get deleted. User associated roles get deleted. For example, in our case, in our case, what's happening? Whenever delete this particular user, this role associated with this role, right? This role get deleted because of on delete cascade type equal to all. Whenever delete this role associated with this user. So here also I'm giving a cascade type equal to all. That's the reason this role also, this record also deleted. I am passing only one ID, but I have totally two records. The two records associated with this particular role, when I delete this user, this user associated with this role, so I'm mentioning in that the POJO object cascade equal to all. That's the reason this role is deleted. While deleting this particular role, what's happening here in the role object also, I'm mentioning cascade equal to all, so this user also get deleted. Whatever record associated with this role, that record also get deleted. That is the reason all the users got deleted. Okay, to avoid this kind of problem, now we are facing two problems. One is the record is deleting, our expected record is deleting, also other records are deleting because of cascade equal to all. To avoid that problem, we need to remove cascade type dot delete. Okay, when you look at all, it has lot of type we have, right? Remove. Except remove, we need to keep it all. Okay. Cascade equal to detach. Cascade equal to merge. Persist. Cascade. Type equal to refresh. Okay, I'm keeping only except delete, I'm keeping others. So same thing we need to do it for the role also, user also. Okay, now we'll restart the server. Let's see what's happening. My database, do you have a record? Yeah, I don't have a record. I'll go and start the application. Application is started. Now go to here, I want again going to add a role and add a to user. See the database, there are two rows, two records added, roles added, and association also added. Okay, now I want to remove record number 22. See 22 is removed, only 23 is there. When look at the role object, role keep available here, user role, we have one record is available. Okay, the problem with the cascade type equal to delete, after removing that, it's properly happened. Okay. I think that's it. I'll give you one assignment, you guys. If you possible, please try that. Okay. I think this is does not involve any coding activities. When you say post method rule, when you add a user, I have given address object, right? Just add this address object while adding a roles for the user. Let's see it's happen adding or not. Definitely it will add. Just try that. If it's not coming, please let me know, I will help you out. Okay, then next session we'll going to see some queries, how to write a Hibernate queries, JPA queries. Please subscribe if you are not yet, share this video to your friend circle, click bell icon for regular updates. Thank you so much for watching this full video. Until next video, bye bye from Suresh K7.